It's truly paradise.
Take a walk with BBC Two following the African footsteps Thursday at 8.
Again, the nation expects. The British Grand Prix live from Silverstone. Tomorrow at 12:35 on BBC Two and throughout the afternoon on BBC Radio 5 Live.
Cricket now on BBC Two with highlights of today's Cup Final from Lords. Introduced by Tony Lewis.
Welcome to the highlights of the 24th Benson Hedges Cup Final, Lancashire against Kent. These teams have never met in this particular Cup Final before, but for Kent, it's a seventh appearance, and no county's appeared here more often than that. £35,000 at stake, and of course, the handsome gold trophy. Let's take a look at the teams. There we have the Kent side, without Mark Benson, their captain. A couple of test players, Aravinda, Silva, Martin McCague, and a side crammed full of all-rounders. As for Lancashire, well, Gallion and Fairbrother are both declared fit, and the other test players, Atherton, Crawley, Wasim Akram is there, but also Peter Martin failed to make it with injured ankle ligaments. The toss, Mike Watkinson and Steve Marsh, jeopardising for Mark Benson, were out. The toss won by Marsh, who put Lancashire into bat. And on what sort of pitch? Well, let's turn to Jeff Boycott.
Well, this pitch is very similar to the test match pitch at Lords. You look at it, it's got cracks all over. It's very dry, a lot of cracks. I think there'll be a little bit of an uneven bounce. I think it's got a nice, fresh, overcast atmosphere, cloudy, rainy. I'm not surprised whoever wins the toss wants to bowl first. I think it's just that sort of pitch that probably won't change all day, but you'd like to bowl on it first. You'd like to get the best out of it. If you can get the side batting first down a bit, then you fancy just knocking off a smallish total. So, all in all, basically a bowler's morning.
And there you see the umpires, David Shepherd and Nigel Plews. John Hampshire, the third umpire. Kent won the toss and are fielding. Let's join the play now at the very first ball of the day. Wren bowls to Atherton.
That's a good start for Lancashire. A neat deflection from Michael Atherton. An unusual stroke. Looked as though it came through very slowly to Atherton. Got a top edge, scooped it up, helped it on sway, way down to deep fine leg.
Yes, it was a helped shot. It wasn't really a pull or anything. He top edged it. Great opportunity for Kent. At one moment, it looked as if he had it. Yes, he did have it. You watch closely, it looks as if the fielder actually gets it in his hands, and then as he falls, there, look, it just sort of comes out as he hits the floor.
Aravinda de Silva, man down at deep pine leg. Oh, good shot. See trademark Atherton stroke off the back foot through cover point. It's beautifully played.
Thank you.
just gave him a little bit of room. Not much, but it was enough for the England captain. Made a lovely stroke.
Well, just a little bit of swing here, just coming down the slope, a little bit of seam then. Not a lot, but just enough to create a false shot.
Oh, well bowled. Very well bowled, that cut back sharply. Steve Marsh appealing for the LBW. Wasn't too worried about the flight of the ball afterwards.
Yes, the ball skidded through quite quickly. Did the batsman for length. Batsman coming forward, then having to rock back, and the ball just beat him. It was a really good shout, that. Comes up the hill. Hits him on the top of the thigh. Not too tall a man.
Good shot, nicely timed and firmly struck. And turning out to be uncatchable. The second bowling change of the morning. Dean Headley comes off at the nursery end. Then Mark Ealham replaces him. Medium fast again, the same sort of style, different action, same style. And Mark Ealham has been a major part of Kent's success in this competition so far this year. Very good all-round cricketer. Starts with a full toss. And firmly hit back. Straight past him. Bringing the 50 up for Lancashire. 52 then, without loss. And this is the first ball of the 14th over. Fine shot, right up on his toes. Dean Headley gives chase, but that's a futile gesture. And that just squeezes through the gap of point. Good stop. Ball travelling up the hill here at Lord's. Matthew Fleming's been in the action really all day. Good chase from him. Great dive too. Managed to make sure he didn't cannon it back over the line, having saved it first time round.
And that gets through as well. So it's two and two balls now. Just squeezing to the gap and running away for four. No big pace on this outfield at Lord's today. Oh. Bowled him. So Kent breakthrough. Really solid opening partnership between Atherton and Gallion ends at 80. And Mark Ealham's the man who's done it.
Well, it was a very needed breakthrough for Kent, but it was really a walking shot, just on the walk. You see, never really positioned to play either a drive or a defensive shot. He just pushed at it and walked into it. But it's an excellent start for Lancashire.
Yes, a good news for England too, that Jason Gallion showed no obvious discomfort from that cracked finger, which kept him off the field in the test match at Edgbaston. John Crawley, the new batsman.
Well placed. Beautiful stroke. Quite a circus act down there, but very effective fielding by the Kent players. And the 100 comes up for Lancashire. Scored in 24 overs and 5 balls is virtually 4 and over. Very steady stuff on a very sound foundation.
And a thick edge, but still 4. That'll be further frustration for the Kent bowlers and the captain. Atherton managed to keep it down well enough and it evaded the man at deep third man.
Yes, it wasn't totally luck that. He did open the face deliberately. Sort of shot you see quite often in one day cricket.
...50 for Michael Atherton, and that's a good knock. He's paced himself perfectly. He did have that early let-off when De Silva dropped the most difficult chance, and now he's reached 50 out of a total of 108 for one.
Yes, a very sensible innings. Well, this is a lovely shot, just getting inside out and easing the ball through the covers. Didn't try to hit it too hard, just opened the face, got inside it, and it fairly raced up the hill.
That's a fine stroke. We've seen Atherton off the back foot play some lovely strokes through cover point today, and that's a classic. Was also a half volley.
Yes, Michael Atherton in good touch. He was almost moving forward into this as soon as it left the bowler's hand.
And once again, good feeling. Kent have lifted themselves in the field. Been some brilliant stuff out there in the last 20 minutes.
There has indeed. It's a pity the bowling hasn't been quite as good.
Straight away, 4 runs. Just steered away into the gap. Mike Atherton deliberately opening the face.
Yes, I think this sums up the way it's gone for Kent and the way Lancashire have been in control. Not a bad ball at all, but it was deliberately sliced away.
Made contact there, it's desperately going to... Oh, it's too far. Too far for Matthew Fleming. Before sliced away but hit very hard at the same time, well away from Trevor Ward. No chance for him at all to cut that off. Just got to hurry. Well, he's managed to get the bail off. Matthew Fleming did very well indeed to collect the ball and just reach the stumps. Nigel Plews taking the option, referring the case to the third umpire. It was a good piece of fielding, had to throw off balance. Fleming couldn't quite get back to the stumps in time to get behind them, and the bail comes off. So he must have broken the wicket as he comes past, or has he? Or was it just at the end? Was it the first time or the second time? Have another look at it. He lunged for the stumps here, takes the ball by the popping crease, with John Crawley a long way out at that stage. as he goes for it the first time. Well, it was the off bell that came off. It seemed to be the leg stump that Matthew Fleming was aiming at. So the decision goes in favour of the batsman. Lovely shot. Just beautifully timed away, dab behind square. Any wit from Matthew Fleming, and the late cut very much on.
Well, this lovely shot to a wide ball is adding insult to injury after the decision for the run out went against Kent.
Nigel Plew is quite rightly taking the option to refer the case to third umpire, and John Hampshire is that man today. Made his decision pretty quickly. Good shot, very firmly struck and perfectly placed. Down the wicket and clipped away. And these pair have now put on exactly 100, of which John Crawley's share 47. So they've complemented each other pretty well. Looking for two and making it comfortably enough. So John Crawley goes to 50. In fact, takes his score to 51. It's been a very handy innings for him. 63 balls it taken him. Now for Lancashire. Oh, well caught. Nicely caught just on the edge of the circle at mid-wicket. David Fulton, the catcher at mid-wicket. Lancashire's second wicket falls at 201. And Mike Atherton falls just 7 short of 100.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a surprise this. He's played so well, Mike Atherton. Very positive from the word go. And finally, Kent got a slice of luck. Better late than never, I suppose. But the Lancashire batsmen have controlled the game right from the word go. Mike Atherton back to his best form, piercing the field basically at will, pushing and running into the gaps, opening the face, played shots front and back foot, and a very good splendid innings. New batsman is Neil Fairbrother. Atherton's innings has been a feature of elegant driving, front foot and back foot, steering and placement. And John Crawley, he came in when the total was well set for Lancashire, but he's just pushed the ball around, not played any big shots. He just scored quite quickly, almost contemptuously.
That's a good shot. That's John Crawley's strength through mid-wicket. Club straight down the ground. Good stuff. Great stuff. Mark Ealham has worked very hard in the outfield. bowled 11 good overs as well. Just crashed straight down the ground. Lancashire on 222, double Nelson. Four runs. Long leg is up. The ball has gone fine of him.
This is that sort of batsman, Neil Fairbrother. Not a big fellow who doesn't whack the ball around, but he somehow manages to get the ball in the gaps. He can run the fielders ragged, make the bowlers look silly.
It's out, and Fairbrother goes. Caught, backward point. Settles for a short but mischievous innings, and he always threatens great things for Lancashire in these one-day matches.
Yes, he'll not be too disappointed. He's kept the scoreboard ticking along. He just sliced it open. The face just sliced open, and it went to backward point, a simple catch. But he always keeps the scoreboard ticking over, and Lancashire in a great position.
Not 13 balls. McCague was the catcher. 236 for three.
No change in the batting order. Graham Lloyd, the new batsman.
Well run. It seemed at the start of that second run that Crawley was on a suicide mission, but he got there.
Yes, and the reason he did, there was a hesitation by the fielder, Aravinda de Silva. I don't think he could believe that they were going to go for two. That hesitation cost Kent.
Oh, had that hit, it would have been curtains.
Well, it's lovely quick thinking there by Graham Cowdery. The ball was hit straight to him, but he thought quickly, picked it up and shied.
That's a good shot. Trevor Ward is doing a wonderful job out there for Kent, sweeping up on the boundary. And that's the 250 up. That's a fine shot. My word, it's a fine shot. Beautiful pickup shot, six runs.
Well, it is a good blow, but it's not so good the ball. This stage of the game, full toss drifting into the pads, just whacked away. This stage of the game, it demands great discipline from the bowlers.
It's in the air. He's caught it. A scything shot from John Crawley. Went straight down to long on, almost behind the bowler. But this is the time, 53rd over. A fine innings of 83 comes to an end.
Well, he's done himself a lot of good, John Crawley, with this innings. A slow off spinner, he just flat bats it. It stays in the air a long time, gives the fielder plenty of opportunity to get under it. And a very simple catch, but... he's done his prospects a lot of good for England, as well as playing exceptionally well for Lancashire.
New batsman, Wasim Akram. And they go. And he must be out. Well, bad luck for Graham Lloyd, who's in good nick. And is in. But Wasim Akram, eager to get off the mark. Just asked a little too much from Lloyd.
Yes, Martin McCague, little off-spinner again, stopped Wasim from hitting him. And a brilliant throw. No fault of Graham Lloyd's, just responding to the call at the stage of the game where you hit and run for everything. He made 12 of 12 balls. See, that was a little off-spinner, tucked him up. And Graham Lloyd backed up, but you can't beat a direct fast throw.
Mike Watkinson, the Lancashire captain, comes in with just two overs to play. 259 for five. That's a big hit. Another full toss, a lot of full tosses coming down at the moment. Four runs.
It's not always easy to strike these as cleanly as this. It's almost a baseball strike by Wasim Akram. And it landed only just really inches in from the rope.
That's out. Wickets are tumbling as fours are coming. Martin McCague takes his second catch in that backward point position, this time off the right-handed Watkinson, who goes for naught.
Well, these wickets are keeping Kent in the game. They've already got a tough task ahead of them to win this match. But at one stage, it looked as though Lancashire were going to be headed for somewhere around the 300 mark. Matthew Fleming again just bowling a little leg cutter, and it was really just steered. Outside edge, Martin McCague's had a lot of work to do in that position, and a backward gully, a deepish gully. Watkinson out for none. Lancashire 266 for six.
Ian Austin is the new batsman. Martin McCague to bowl the final over to Ian Austin. Well run.
Yes, he'd made his mind up early, Wasim Akram. He doesn't mind giving the strike back to Ian Austin. He was well down that pitch, didn't really bother to look when he came back. And the ball not taken cleanly.
Just one run, and so we come to the final ball of the Lancashire innings. It's a full toss, the fielder doesn't pick it out. They'll take easy two, will they go for three? They try. And fall short. But two runs to Wasim Akram at the end, who's lost his wicket, doesn't seem too pleased. 273 is the final score, and it's worth noting that the highest score to win a match, batting second in this Benson Hedges final, 244. Well, that was a very strong foundation at the top between Atherton and Gallion, putting on 80 for the first wicket. But then Atherton and Crawley really accelerated. 121 was their partnership of 154 balls. And I guess Lancashire fell a little short of their own expectations, but 274 for seven wickets is in fact the second highest total in this particular final. Tough time out there for the bowlers, but way above the rest, Mark Ealham, with length and line and perseverance, 11 overs, 1 for 33. He was by far the best, but we ought to mention the Kent fielding, which was sharp and accurate all round the field. So Kent required 275 runs to win the match at 5 runs per over. Let's join them now at the second ball of the second over. Chapel bowls to Fulton with 1 run on the board.
Well, there's a good shot from Fulton. That was right off the meat of the bat.
Well, that was quite a quick delivery. Worked up a nice pace straight away as Wasim Akram bounced here, hit him on the shoulder. Really seemed to pick it up too well, the batsman.
What a good shot. It's a short run, and it was almost as though Fulton had worked out that it was going to be short. It's a brilliant stroke.
It was. I think he heard the no ball call, but even if he heard it, he had to be quick. Wasim Akram just overstepping, because he's bowling at a fairly sharp pace. It's not a quick pitch, but he's bowling at a fairly lively pace, is Wasim Akram.
Stroke. The pull shot was brilliantly executed, and that one off his toes, he has clipped away in front of square leg. Well, there don't seem to be any nerves around there. It's a big occasion for David Fulton. David Lloyd is the man on the left, the coach of his Lancashire team. Once again, the bowler straying round about leg stump. That's the third time Chapel has done that. And this time, Trevor Ward has taken full advantage.
Yeah, Shung Chapel just pushing it into the pads. Juicy half volley dispatched. No great pace in the pitch, just clipped it away.
Lancashire coach Brow is not quite furrowed yet, but maybe shortly. First one gone. Trevor Ward is out. Ben Chappell has taken him. Ward has been so consistent with two centuries and three half centuries in this competition this year. Goes for seven, caught by Warren Hegg. Seven from 11 balls, and Kent 28 for one.
Yes, and it was the bounce that did him. Len Chappell getting the ball to bounce and carry through to the keeper. Just got the top edge. I mentioned this pitch doesn't have a lot of bounce, but he got one there to bounce off the seam. Carry very nicely to the keeper. Well, bowl, disappointment for Kent. Throughout the day, most of the things have gone Lancashire's way.
Neil Taylor is the new batsman, coming out to join David Fulton, and it's 28 for one.
Not a good shot. David Fulton knows it too. Never short enough, really, to go onto the back foot. Ian Austin, the only man to bowl one maiden over today, and quickly turns it into two. shot. Great shot. David Fulton very quick on anything short.
Yes, they've been tied down a little bit, so he's taking the opportunity here. One of the few that's been presented to him. Banged in, just a touch short. You have to go and fetch it a long way from off stump.
Close and got him. It kept low for David Fulton. A little bit of bad luck for the man making his debut in this competition.
Well, after one ball that sat up quite nicely for him to pull, this one just keeping low, nipping back in front. A bit unlucky is that. I said all along this pitcher has got a bit of an uneven bounce about it, bit of low bounce. And he played very well for those 25 or 49 balls. And his disappointment I could feel for him, because you don't expect the ball to die on you quite like that. Aravinda de Silva. Kent need a big innings from him.
Got a hold of that one. A scar all the way. Six runs to Aravinda de Silva. That was a wonderful shot. Able to get right underneath it, Aravinda de Silva. Dropped it just in front of the scoreboard by the mound, by the tavern stand, between the mound and tavern stands there. Has another go. Well, just look at that. Six more. David Shepherd being kept fully busy.
Well, these are wonderful shots by Aravinda. Step forward and then swinging onto the back foot and swinging the bat even harder.
The first boundary for Neil Taylor. Effectively put away behind the square, just given that little bit of extra width by Glenn Chappell. He's aimed over the top, he's got it, two bounces, three bounces, and into the rope. Fetch that back. Bottom hand came off the bat, it didn't make any difference at all to the power of the shot. Really rifled it square on the offside.
71 for two. Seven of those to Aravinda de Silva, 25 to Fulton. He was OBW to Chappell, and Chappell took the wicket of Ward as well. De Silva has striked to Watkinson, and he's bowling from the nursery yet. Beautifully played. It's gone for four. He doesn't mind giving them the charge. Has gone in the air. Oh, that will have Lancashire hearts dropping. Glenn Chappell, and he slightly overran it. He was coming in for the catch, suddenly found it was getting at him too quickly. Might even have hit him in the shoulder or the chest. A good shot from Taylor. Beautifully placed. Oh, bowled him. That's well bowled. Beautifully flighted ball. Harry Yates has been pushing it through to Neil Taylor. Just drawing him down a little, and that was beautifully flighted. Gave it plenty of air. 81 for 3 now, Kent. Neil Taylor bowled by Yates for 14.
As Taylor just came down that little bit too far, managed to York himself. He'd already been down the pitch once in the over and struck a four, but that's good bowling.
Aravinda to Silva, 32 not out. Graham Cowdery is the man coming in to join him. Good square drive. It's beaten the man at backward point, fielding inside that fielding circle. And beat the man out on the boundary as well.
Yes, nice bit of width. He hit it late. Sliced away. Not much chance of catching those when they run down the hill. Nice bit of urgency there in the running, brought up the 100 for Kent.
Now it's over 6.3 for the first time past the six mark. Current rate 3.84. So Kent now require, in effect, a run from every ball. Beautifully done. Good cricket combination there with Glenn Chappell and Ian Austin and wicketkeeper Warren Hegg, who did a good job. That's good running to bring up Aravinda de Silva's 50. A fine half century from the Sri Lankan.
At this stage, heavy rain stopped play. There was a break of about 35 minutes, and we rejoin the match now at the resumption with 25 overs still to go, and Kent needing a further 156 to win.
Cowdery's employed that stroke a number of times against the off-spinner, and three from that over. To score along now to 122 for three. Neatly done. Got it away from that man at short third man. And this time it can't be saved. Now that asking rate has gone up to 6.47. But the current run rate has stayed above four now for quite some time. Aravinda de Silva now will be looking for this over from Gary Yates, the off spinner, to make up for Austin's bowling in the last over. Well, there's a request there from wicketkeeper Warren Hegg. His leg by signalled, and Hegg would have gone up for that because Aravinda de Silva went so far across his crease.
Yes, he did shuffle across, but that ball just going down the hill, and it's worth a shout, but I can assure you the ball really does go to leg side from bowling from the pavilion end. It runs down that slope very quickly.
Yes, gone this time. Graham Cowdery has given out OBW. Umpire Shepherd has given him. It all looked as though it had turned. Pitch is outside off. The interesting one will be the camera shot from side on to show how far the batsman was down, because the ball certainly turned a little, not much, but it did turn a little.
Well, it's a pity he decided to have a slog to leg, because they were playing so well, and he's a long way down the pitch. Not an elegant shot at all, but you can see how far he gets down there. It's a very big stride. I have to feel that he's a bit unlucky.
142 for four, with De Silva not out, 62. And the new man is Matthew Fleming. Shouting, and umpire Plews is sufficiently impressed, standing out at point, to call for the third umpire adjudication. The wicketkeeper thought for a moment he was a square leg and looked there, first of all. And Fleming is in deep trouble there, I would say. Now the wicketkeeper turns to look at the umpire at square. Well, it will be very lucky if Fleming can survive there, because on the line is out.
Well, if the pictures aren't that clear, he's got to give him not out. And that's what John Hampshire has done. Third umpire.
That's four. That's broken the shackles, and Gary Yates is very disappointed with that full toss. He's been bowling very well. Just gave that one a bit too much air, and De Silva took full advantage of it. Well, that's well placed, over the top of backward point. And right at the end of the over, Austin was putting everything into the delivery. It was quite short, and Fleming crashed it away. Now, there is a man in for that little sweep shot for Fleming. It's a sensible move. May make him hit out on the onside. And in fact, that's precisely what it's done. Not necessarily on the onside, but Gary Yates has put the man in at fine leg to stop the sweep, and Fleming now has tried to hit it away over extra cover. And he's gone, and so is the fifth wicket. And Mark Ealham originally was listed to come in ahead of Matthew Fleming, but now he's coming at the fall of Fleming's wicket. ...71 for Aravinda De Silva. And the faster one's produced a four. Now that's a very good over for Aravinda De Silva and Kent.
Big shot there, he's out. Mark Ealham. He goes for three, LBW, Bill Watkinson. 180 for six.
Well, this is a big problem for Kent. They keep losing wickets, playing right across this ball, nipping back. Nip back, up the hill. Really did play across it. And they keep slowly and surely losing wickets. New batsmen struggling to get going and to keep Aravinda De Silva company.
So very much depends now on Aravinda De Silva 82 not out. He needs all the strike possible. He needs to play an attacking innings. 11 overs left, 95 more runs required, and the run rate almost up to 9 per over now. Return of Glenn Chappell now. Very handy little nick for De Silva. Just what Kent need. Oh, I think that Glenn Chappell could well do without it. Just what Kent require. They got up to 9 and over required and 2 fours of 2 balls.
Well, somebody's got to play a bit special to get 9.22 runs per over with only 4 wickets left.
And it could be Aravinda De Silva. Takes him to 98, 6 over square leg. Super shot. Beautifully placed. And that's a century for Aravinda De Silva. Studied with some glorious shots. Strong pull shots for 6 and delicate cuts and glances. And a standing ovation. One of the most economical of Lancashire's bowlers, 9 overs for 30, and out of those 30 runs were 2 sixes, both struck by Aravinda. It's in the air. It's caught him. Graham Lloyd's caught it at mid-wicket. Well, Aravinda had very little option. He really had to play some shots and some big shots. An excellent catch at deep mid-wicket. A quite superb innings.
Yes, it was superb. Orthodox cricket shots, drives, pulls. First ball, tries to flip it for 6, and it doesn't quite carry. Only to Graham Lloyd. But it was a top-class performance. The figures 112 off 95 balls, and they were all quality cricket shots, no slogs.
Martin McCague, the new batsman. Well, well, well. Two balls. Ian Austin can't believe his luck.
Well, Steve Marsh there trying to turn Ian Austin to leg, got a leading edge, and it was just a little bit of a cuckoo then to short cover. Now this is the leading edge. Steve Marsh just trying to work it to leg, leading edge, and just cuckooed up to short cover. Dean Headley, new batsman.
Lofted high in the air, taken comfortably. The improvised shot not working this time. Glenn Chappell takes the catch that sees the fall of Dean Headley and Kent's 9th wicket. And their dream of winning the Benson Hedges Cup this year, all but shattered.
Yes, at this stage of the game, it's difficult for number 10 to get 10 runs and over. It's hard enough for batsmen. I'm trying an improvised shot, but just chips it to the short fine leg.
The last man for Kent, Tim Wren. The crowd poised for the post-match invasion. Chance for run out, he's got to just hurry back.
Yeah!
Has he made it? And the game could be decided on the call of the third umpire. John Hampshire has the decision to make now, which could finally award this trophy, the Benson Hedges Cup, to Lancashire this evening. The throw coming in, controlled throw in from John Crawley. Wasim Akram has taken the bails off. And the ball needs to be in the hands. Unless the ball itself has hit the stump, batsman's leg stump as it would have been, and the decision not out. Well, that's hit high, high in the air. Ian Austin underneath it at long on. Looks very calm, is very calm, takes the catch. And Lancashire are the Benson and Hedges champions for 1995 by the margin of 35 runs. A very competent Lancashire performance. Mike Watkinson has grabbed his stump, his souvenir of the trophy victory here. The first trophy of the season is decided, and Lancashire are the winners.
Well, truly one magnificent innings by Aravinda de Silva. His 50 in 50 balls and 100 off only 88 balls, but he was always losing wickets at the other end. Only Graham Cowdery hung around, and then briefly. But the bowlers, they had a superb day, especially young Yates, 3 for 42. Ian Austin, very economical in spite of a couple of sixes, 2 for 36. And Mike Watkinson, the captain, 3 wickets for him as well. So Lancashire win the match by 35 runs. And the Gold Cup was presented to Mike Watkinson, the Lancashire skipper, up on the balcony in front of many admiring and cheering fans at the end of the match. And the gold award to the Sri Lankan test player, Aravinda de Silva. And afterwards I spoke to them both, de Silva and the Lancashire captain, Mike Watkinson.
Mike, many congratulations. You've got quite, noisy support here.
Yeah, we've had great support all day. They enjoy the victory as much as we do.
Some good batting at the start laid a very firm foundation, didn't it?
Yeah, when we got asked to bat this morning, we knew we needed a good start, which we could build on. We perhaps maybe could have got a few more runs with the start we got, but Kent bowlers kept us pretty tight and got a score which we could defend anyway.
Yeah, I had the feeling at the end that you fell below your own expectations, really.
Yeah, the Thunderbirds down the order, who normally do all the rescue operations, they didn't quite get as many runs as we thought we could have done, maybe fell 20 runs short. And it was a game where Kent pushed us all the way. Aravinda played brilliantly. We couldn't really bowl to him, and it was just lucky for us that we could chip away at the fellas at the other end and keep breaking up the partnerships.
Some young bowlers bowled particularly well for you.
Yeah, Gary Yates, he gives us the variety with the off-spin. He works very hard at his game, thinks it through a lot, and I think he got some good rewards today and performed very well for us.
Well, congratulations to you and to all the team.
Thank you.
And congratulations, but commiserations, Aravinda, because you played superbly and yet your team lost.
I know, I was a bit disappointed at the end, but I'm sure Lancashire played well and they deserved to win as the best team who came out of the performance today.
Did you think as you were batting that you could win it, possibly? You got up to 9 and over you needed?
Yeah, I knew because wickets were falling at the other end, so I knew I had to hang around till the last couple of overs. And what I was looking for was a boundary every over, and to try and push it around in the next 5 balls.
I'm not sure that Ian Austin's going to forgive you for hitting a couple of sixes or more, because he's one of the most economical bowlers I have ever seen in this competition.
I know, I kept on playing my usual game, and every loose ball I thought I'll punch it as well as I could.
Well, enjoy the prize, and again, well batted.
Thanks very much.
How rare it is for a player from the losing side to come away with the gold award, but that was an innings to remember, no doubt about that. Our next cricket comes up a week on Thursday at Old Trafford. That's the fourth Cornhill Test match. Look forward to seeing you then. From us all at Lord's, good night.
takes the